joining me as a very special guest, GM of the Edmonton Oilers, Ken Holland. That must be a little bit different to hear that, and obviously the emblem on your, you still feel a little weird about it, or is it getting a little bit more comfortable?
I'm getting used to it, yeah. 36 years, obviously, with the Red Wing uniform, or Red Wing logo, but excited to be back out west.
Absolutely, and this is pretty convenient. You live, what, 2 miles from here?
Yeah, this is 5 miles. I live on 7 miles. I used to come to about 10, 15 U.S. Under 18 games, so I've been here a lot.
Is it safe to say Edmonton's starting to feel a little bit more like home now, though?
Yeah, we're excited. Bought a place and a condo. It's still being built, but I'm here now for a couple of weeks with my wife. We're going to work on our way to getting the for sale sign up on our house here.
Right, packing up all the boxes, yeah. All that good stuff. The first thing you did with the Edmonton Oilers was draft Philip Broberg from Sweden. They played earlier today in what was a hard-fought match with Finland. Great game. Your thoughts on his play so far?
I thought he played very, very good. You know, when you had the eighth pick in the draft, there's obviously a lot of good players. You know, I was talking to him the other day. He said he's grown an inch in the last couple of months.
There you go.
He's over 6'4". He's mobile. He can skate. Likes to join the rush, you know, the new wave defenseman. I thought he was competitive. I thought he played very, very well this week.
And these are your prospects that are here. Your thoughts, basically. How familiar are you with all of the prospects?
I know him pretty good. I was out scouting with the Red Wings, so I watched some of these players when they were, Rodrigue played really good. He's a good goalie tender. Obviously, he's in a competition here for the for the World Junior team, but he needs to have all these guys need to play great in October, November, and December, and worked their way on the team, but certainly all good prospects.
Absolutely. Jesse Puljujärvi recently mentioned that, you know, the NHL is still a destination that where he wants to play. Nonetheless, he wants to play in Europe until he can find another place to play. Is that still holding true, or how are talks going with him?
Oh, that's holding. I talked recently with his agent again, and nothing's really changed. So in the next couple of weeks here, I got to heat up the phone lines and see if I can find a solution. Otherwise, Europe is probably the only solution, but we'll see what happens.
You've been a busy man, moving Lucic, Ratti, Reeder to name a few, acquiring James Neal, Mike Smith, and Granlund to name a couple others. Outside of Puljujärvi, can we expect much more action from the Edmonton Oilers and yourself?
No, I think Jesse's the last move that I got to make. We've tried to, obviously we got James Neal, we're trying to build a top six and change the makeup. I'm excited about working with Dave Tippett behind the bench. He's put his staff together. We just hired the University of Michigan assistant coach Brian Wiseman the other day to complete his staff. So anxious to get to training camp and hopefully have some competition for jobs. We need some depth and we need some competition for spots.
Well, best of luck. We appreciate you taking the time and coming to chat with us here. You're always a good friend of our show, so thanks,
no problem.
Ken.
Thanks, Tessa.